Good afternoon, everyone. It's mathematic time, online lesson one. And this is for grade 7. Topics of today, or the topic of today is common fractions, whereby we are comparing fractions. My name is Mr. Dumi from Namibia Primary School, Windhoek. Today's objective is to compare common fractions and mixed numbers with denominators up to 10 using the relationship signs. The words that we need to know before we start. Need to start with fractions, whereby if we are to define fraction is part of the whole. For example, the total is 5, as our denominator is indicated here, and 3 is part of that 5. In a diagram form, you can show that by, as indicated by the red color, which is 3 columns are shaded in red out of the total, which is 5. Other words that you need to know before we start. 1 in fractions is considered as a whole. When we have a fraction with a denominator which is 2, is considered as half. 3 as a denominator, we say third. 1 out of 4, we say is a quarter or quarters. 1 out of 5, we say 1/5, or the denominator which is 5, we consider that as 5th. 6 as 6th, 8 as 8th, 9 as 9th, and 10 as 10th. We use relationship signs to compare fractions. And the signs are shown there in brackets, whereby the one opening to the right is smaller than, to the left is bigger than or greater than, and equal to. When comparing fractions having the same numerators, the fraction with the smaller denominator is the fraction. Looking at the example, when comparing two fractions which are having the same numerator, the first one is having 2 and 2, the fraction with the smaller denominator is the biggest fraction, and in this case there is 2/3 and 2/5. So 3 is smaller than 5. So that means this fraction is bigger because it is having a denominator which is small, using this sentence or the instruction. Coming to this example number 2, the two fractions are having the same numerators and the denominators are different. But according to the instruction, the fraction with a smaller denominator is the biggest fraction. You can do number 3 and see if you get it right. We cannot just depend on this instruction. In science and math, you need to prove things. So you can also use the shapes to compare fractions. The first shape represents the first fraction, and the second one represents 2/5. If you look at the first shape, it is having 3 columns. That is the total, and that is your denominator. The second one is having 5, and that is your denominator. The numerator is what is shaded in red. The shaded part in the first shape is 2, and in the second one is 2, because first fraction is 2/3, and the second one is 2/5, the same numerator. The shape of the same size, length. You cannot draw a shape one is taller than the other. To be of the same height. By shading your numerator, you will be able to tell which fraction is bigger than the other, the shaded part, which one is bigger. So you can see that the first one is bigger than the second one. You can draw another shape here. The same techniques that I used in the first example, Paul. And then you should be able to prove that yes, 5/6 is bigger than 5/8. You can compare the third example using the signs, and you can also draw a shape just to show. The second one, I want to give you a hint, so I'm going to use a highlighter, or maybe I should use a pen. I use a highlighter, and then it's not visible. I must use another one. I use a pen. I will draw the first fraction, which is 5/8. I will say this is 1. Total should be 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is 8. And the one which are shaded, they should be 5. This one is shaded. This one is shaded. This one is shaded. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I must shade. I have shaded 5. And the 3 are not shaded, so I have to draw again. Now it should be the same, should be the same length. Then it should be divided into 6, so I will divide here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can see that I'm supposed to make a little bit longer this first. But anyways, we need to shade 5 of them. So if I have to shade 5, I shade 5, I'll shade 5. How many did I do? 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5. Now to compare this one, this is for this fraction, and this is for this fraction. Now you can tell that the part which is shaded goes until here, and the part which is shaded here goes until here. You can tell that the first fraction is smaller than the second fraction. Using the same technique that I've applied here, you need to draw your own here and you need to compare. So please do that one. When comparing fractions, make sure denominators are the same. Change the denominators if they are not the same to become the same. And the second example here involves fractions which are of different types. We have mixed number with a proper fraction here. We have a mixed number and a mixed number. We have a mixed number and another mixed number. Therefore, if we are to compare the first one, if you change this fraction to become improper, you see that the numerator will become very big. You can use that method and compare, it's up to you. Or you can still draw shapes, as I have indicated, it's up to you. You can make denominators the same, it's up to you. So the first method, you can make denominators the same. You make denominators the same. The second option, you can do shapes. It's up to you. So you can use these two methods and compare this fraction. Let us look at the first one. How do I know that this fraction is bigger than this one? This 7 out of 9 or 7 ninth is less than 1. This is less than 1. Is less than 1. Let me just put it like that. Meaning 1 is bigger than 7 out of 9. And if you look at this fraction, 4 is a whole number and 4 is already bigger than 1. So in that case, we are not going to waste time and make the denominator the same or draw shapes. You can already tell that this is way, way bigger than this fraction. Therefore, the crocodile will eat what is big. But one is asking a question, how do I draw this shape? How do I draw shapes to represent 4 and 1/3? 4 and 1/3, you draw it this way. You draw it this way. You have the denominator is 3, so you need to divide this into 3. So this whole thing is shaded. That is 1. You draw another one, same size, divide into 3. And this whole thing is shaded. That is another one. So together, this is 2. And we need to go for 4. We need to go for 4. You done. You divide into 3. You shade everything. That's another one. And then you draw you sheet everything, and that is another one. So this is now 1, 2, 3, 4. This is now 4 as a whole number. Everything is shaded, consider that. And the last one you are doing, sorry about that, using mouse. The last one to represent this fraction, of course, you just have to shade 1, because one is a numerator and the total is 1, 2, 3. So this is 1/3. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1/3. So look at all this. These are all shaded and this. But if you look at this, to compare this, it's just 7/9. That is the same size as this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we are only shading 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Shades. So if you look at this compared to space, you can tell that this is bigger than that. So that is how you draw a shape and compare. By using this shape, I believe you already understand. You understand how you can do this one. I think this one will be much easier after listening to what I've done here. So in this case, there is a 4 and there is a 2. Don't waste time. You already know the crocodile will eat what is big. And in this case, you have 2 and 2. And here you have 2 and 2. That is already equal. 2. Whole numbers, we have 2 and we have 2. Okay, fractions, how about fractions? Fractions, you have 2/8, and here you have 3/8. We must change our denominators. We must change our need to same. And you see the denominator here is the same. All we need to compare is the numerator. Sorry, these two. The numerator. And you can see that 3 is bigger than 2. So this is the biggest fraction. So the first one is the biggest fraction, but you can also use a method of drawing for you to know what I mean, to know which fraction is big. So I'm trying to erase all these just to make sure that everything is erased. Yeah, and there's supposed to be even a heading somewhere here. I don't know whether it will come. Same one you can make use. The heading is supposed to come first. Something happened there. My apology for that. I cannot leave you without doing anything, so I'll give you a practical activity work for lesson one. You need to do this on your own. I believe you can watch this video over and over for you to understand all the examples I've done. So try these 10 fractions pairs so that you can get to submit it on Wednesday. Today is 27th, so Wednesday is 29th. So the due date of this is 29th, which is Wednesday. And I'll urge everyone to read it. Please do not please do not share the answers on the group. At the WhatsApp group, you can just ask me a question, but all the answers must be forwarded via WhatsApp to my number. We go 81 732 6609. Send your answers to this number via WhatsApp, and I'll be able to mark them and forward the feedback back to you. I wish you all the best. Good luck. This is the beginning. We just started, and I hope that you get everything right. Try and try. And I also load this video on YouTube. I'll share the link on the group. From me, Mr. Dumi, say goodbye, enjoy, and bye-bye.